Welcome to the Makerspace. Now, before you can use the equipment here, we do require you go through small safety training and then get yourself some hands-on experience with the equipment where you will print out your badge that will serve as your license to come in and use the equipment that you've been certified on. So let's do that today and let's start talking about 3D printers. Now, 3D printing describes a large array of technology, not just the ones that you'll see here in the Makerspace. There's SLA and DLP 3D printers, which use a light curing liquid polymer that they use a laser to make solid, and then they pull the object out of this liquid, and it's really cool. And we don't have any of those right now. There's also powder-based 3D printing that fills up the print area with a powder that it binds together, either with a liquid glue, or sometimes the powder is metal and they use a high-powered laser to melt it together. They use this to build parts for airplanes. And after the print is done, they just reach into the powder and pull the 3D printed part out, and it's super cool. We don't have those either. The 3D printers that we have here are a variation of the FDM or FFF technology that's been around for a number of years with people building them in their garages. The printers that we have here are a step above that, but they still run on the same principle. Now, FDM stands for fused deposition modeling, but when hobbyists started making these 3D printers, it came to light that that term was copyrighted by a corporation, so they came up with the term FFF, which stands for fused filament fabrication, both of which describe the same technology, and any of these printers that call themselves FFF have these same component parts, and so you can find them on any of them, even though they might be a little bit different on each one. The first part that they all share is a piece of software on your computer, so the computer is actually a part of the 3D printer for now, and that software is called a slicer. A slicer takes a 3D model, which in and of itself isn't really ready to be 3D printed, and turns it into instructions that the 3D printer will follow. Like its name implies, it takes the model and makes a very thin slice of it, then looks at the shape of that slice and goes, okay, if the 3D printer is going to make that, it's going to have to start here, start squirting out plastic, then it's going to have to move this way and draw the shape this way, and then it's going to have to move here to fill it in. And it takes those instructions and you move them over to the 3D printer, and the 3D printer follows them. Now, the 3D printer, the first thing it's going to need to do is load in some filament, this thin noodle of plastic. So the filament, kind of part of the 3D printer. And also, somewhere on the 3D printer, you will find a feed system, a motor that pulls the filament in and drives it in through the printer. Now, if you look at these 3D printers, where might the feed system be? If you look at the minis here, the feed system is a motor right here on top with a gear that pulls it in through this tube to the next part. However, on the Ultimaker here, you might think that the motor is right here next to the hot end, but it's not. It's here on the back, hidden away where you can't really see it. Some 3D printers do have their feed system much closer to the nozzles, but they all have one, and that's the point. Now, after the feed system does its job, it's pushing the filament through, and the filament is going to the hot end. We call this the hot end because, you guessed it, it does get hot, about 200 degrees Celsius, hot enough to melt the plastic and squirt it out of a little opening that it has so that it comes out in a fine spray. Now, if we stopped here, we wouldn't have a 3D printer. We'd just have a filament melter and squirter. But once it's moving that filament out, it needs to move it in three dimensions. So it needs to move in the X, in the Y, and then up and down in the Z. And you'll notice the mini printer moves the bed to do this, but the Ultimaker doesn't. It moves around the top in the X and the Y, and the build plate comes up and then comes down to it to get the Z direction. The Delta 3D printer here is really cool, actually, because it uses three motors that go just up. And in order to move up, if it wants to move up, all three of those motors have to move up. If it wants to move left, one of them goes down, the other one comes up. It's really a very neat coordinated dance. But the point is, the feed system All FFF 3D printers need to have at least three motors to move in three dimensions to give us the 3D in 3D printing. Now lastly, there's a build plate where the print goes afterwards. And here in the Makerspace, all of these build plates are heated. They'll get up to about 60 degrees centigrade, which is almost hot enough to warm up a tortilla, but it's probably not going to hurt you too bad. However, now that you know the parts of the 3D printers, most of the parts of them, I want you to take a look at them, think about them for a second, and think, where could this machine try to hurt me? How could it try to damage me, and what are the danger points? So did you have a chance to guess at some of the danger points? There are, in fact, four that we need to think of. Now, the most obvious, of course, is the hot end. Yes, it gets hot, and if you touch it while it's running, it might leave you with a pretty good welt, so that's one. Another one is that these are electrical machines. They are pulling in electricity, and electricity can generate sparks, so you gotta keep an eye out for that. Now, another one is we have a movement system here, and this movement system doesn't care if you or your dangling jewelry or loose-fitting clothing or hair is getting in the way. It's going to try to move anyways, so while it's moving, you might want to keep that in mind. The last one, and not a lot of people get this, but maybe you did, is that we are melting a polymer, and in doing so, we might generate fumes that may make things get a little bit heady. So for these reasons, for these danger problems, we have some simple rules that we need to follow here in the Makerspace. And these rules are posted on the wall, and so if you ever forget them or need to refer to them later, you know where to look at them. The rules are this. Number one, don't keep flammable items near the 3D printer. This includes papers and chemicals that might catch on fire. We might need to use these chemicals sometimes, or we might need to have a piece of paper near it, but don't store them near them. Secondly, do not wear loose-fitting clothing or dangling jewelry near the 3D printer, especially during its operation. Just take off the tie and put the bracelets away for a little while, just while the 3D printer is running for safety. And third, watch the 3D printer as it's laying down the first print or first layer. Make sure that that's going down well before you walk away from it, and then keep an eye on it as much as you can. Now, 3D printing is a slow process. It's probably going to take 24 hours for a larger print to print, and so I don't expect you to watch it constantly. I do expect that you'll be going home at some point and sleeping, so just keep an eye on it as much as you can during the process, and don't leave it until you're relatively sure that it's going to work. There are some other things, some generally good ideas. Number one, keep an eye on the equipment. Take a look at it before you use it. Make sure that the wiring's good, that there's nothing obviously wrong with the equipment. If there is, be sure to tell a lab worker what you see, and we'll be sure to give these 3D printers the TLC that they need. Secondly, always be sure to use 3D printers in a well-ventilated area, a large room that you can let the fumes dissipate in, and we even have fans here, so if you feel like things are getting a bit heady, we can turn them on, but that's always a good idea with 3D printers. And lastly, should things get the worst, we have fire extinguishers and first aid kit by the door, so you can go ahead and use those should things get to it. All right, enough talking. It's time to take the quiz, sign the waiver, and then do the 3D printing project to make your 3D printing badge. If you're not already at the Makerspace, it's time to get there. That's it for this video. I want to thank you very much for watching, and I will see you at the Makerspace.